will have a good time, but because I'm obviously going to like the cycling part. The weather's beautiful, the countryside is beautiful, and to think that everything else is going to be taken care of, the food, the stay, the nutrition, everything is okay, all of that. I'm also glad to meet the people that are going to be on this trip. Because I don't really get a chance to meet people. It's just for work. I just meet people to work all the time. But this would be one of the things that I'm going out with the group. And I don't know that, and we just get a little further in the cycle. So all of these things, I think, would kind of stand out. But to experience that through their eyes was fun.
Yeah. And then what's your takeaway from trips like these? I mean, once when you're going with your family, you know,
yes.
You have selected people who you know.
Yes.
And now you're going on a trip with people who don't know.
Yes.
So what's your takeaway from both of them?
I think it's like I said, it's nice to get to know people outside of the workspace. You know, mostly, I don't socialize a lot. I used to until about 25 years ago. But since then, I have a lot of my own businesses which I spend a lot of time with. And when I travel, it's mostly for an event. We are organizing or participating. I never socialize. So this is a great opportunity to just meet someone. And I haven't created that opportunity. It's just like it's come to me, which is interesting. So it's nice to meet new people once in a while. And who share, of course, a liking for something like this, similar sensibilities.
And the destination, what do you think in terms of eating? Like, this is there, what are you looking for?
Well, if you know a lot about the traditional Portuguese cuisine, do you know? It's terrible. having walked through the countryside, I know. So, of course, they love it. But and there are certain things like they have a really delicious soup called the caldo de vegetable soup, which is mostly what I ate while I was there. But everywhere in Europe, when you see the traditional food, most of it is boiled. It's just boiled.
Blank.
The meat is boiled, the rice is boiled, the potatoes are boiled. That's all. So it takes a bit of getting used to. But the places that I think we're going to visit will offer a more fusion cuisine. And so when you take certain elements, it's like how the French cuisine has developed. It is still French, but it's not the traditional French. So you take certain elements from France, certain elements from Asia, you know, mix it all beautifully, and you make something really delicious. So that is also something that I hope. Yeah, because in this kind of a trip, that's what I would expect. not live a tricycle, even when you were a kid.
That's tricycle.
It
was a very fat kid.
What I was saying that a lot of people now will learn to cycle to be on this road. Is it amazing?
Yes.
So what's the profile?
So we will be, so this basically is between 25 to 45 years of age group are who are more interested in driving this trip. It's basically for couples also who have been like wanting to do some active tourism, and these are the interests that we are looking for.
And are
they
kids right now?
Yes, they are.
Yes, fashion bloggers. Ask me something.
I just wanted to know the other one.
My chappals?
Yeah.
I wear these chappals, they're my favorite chappals.
What's the color?
It's a company in, I think it's in Calicut, called Metis.
Metis.
M-E-T-H-Y-S. But they have very beautiful colors. And you can mix and match the colors, so it's not so different, so we have to give you the option. But they have a lot of stores across the south, so they're not in the north yet. But I've been wearing these kind of chappals for almost 25 years. Because I do questions. About 7-8 years ago.
And what made you?
So it was to explore the natural way to run. So when you do something, any activity, you know, after some time, you really want to see how it could be better, how the experience could be better, what is the best way to do it, get more efficient. And of course, you know that running is a natural activity. We never used to wear shoes as we evolve into things to run. So I, this is before, now there's a big debate. So this is a little bit before the debate in India. Is barefoot running better, or shoes are better, or what is better? And I just one day thought, you know, I finished a 20-kilometer run, took off my shoes, and I ran the last 1 kilometer in my socks. And suddenly I felt that my feet felt very refreshed, very energized. And I realized that inside the shoe, my foot had got muscles were tired, the shoe, my foot was cramped inside the shoe. And I've been wearing shoes, running shoes for almost 7-8 years before that. I started running in 2004. So running, when I'm saying that, it's long distance. So it was an interesting feeling, and I decided to explore. just started feeling so good about being barefoot that I never went back to shoes. So I discovered that the way I was running was changing every time I ran barefoot. So my posture, my balance, my footfall, the way my body was, my shoulders would be, my hips, because your hips tilt. You know, all of that was being affected by the feel of the ground. And it's important because when you see that your hands and your feet are the two parts of your body that are always in contact with your ground. So they are actually telling your body how to respond. It's not that you think, like, what should I do here, what should I do that. Your body is telling you itself, which you don't normally discipline. We've lost that connection. So when you are barefoot, it tells you how to stand, how to walk, how to run, how to bend, how to reach and pick up something. So because those signals are constantly, trillions of signals per second, it's faster than you think. And your body is completely then in sync with what it needs to do because of that feeling. So that's something that I have discovered, that feeling.
Barefoot,
maybe
you run with socks on.
No, without skin touch. I mean, everything's like it's dirty and all.
No, I'm just wondering, where would you run?
Everywhere.
Everywhere.
I run on the highway. I run from Bombay to Ahmedabad to Bombay barefoot on the highway.
It's like running in the other.
Antarctica. I mean, after this, they take me to Antarctica.
As we are the so we always tend to do something very different. So last year, we did our first day over in Antarctica, training about 100 people from here, where we had a full budget to take care of meals and everything. This year, again, we are taking 100 people to Antarctica. We are bringing in the new year in Antarctica. That's one thing that we are doing this year. We are doing something. Polar bear migration in the Arctic polar region. It's happening as a polar bear migration, we call it. We recently are doing something in Portugal with Milind. These are the things that we are already doing.
This is in November.
We are
talking probably in
December. December.
Maybe in a way that I
have. Have you explored South America?
But it's huge.
Oh, no.
I've been to a few countries. I've been to Brazil, I've been to Venezuela, I've been to Costa Rica. Costa Rica is, of course, in Central America. There's a few countries, not a lot. I'd love to go, but it's very far. It's very huge. Fashion blogger, ask me a question. Nothing else.
Do you miss being on the runway?
No, not really.
How long is that?
So in the last 22, 23 years, I may have done 3 or 4 shows. And the last one may have been 4 or 5 years.
Yeah.
साहब बाहर जाओ या
Jaja.
Okay.